Hi, and welcome to the 7th episode of my new showcast. My name is Gary, and this channel exists so that you can always stay up to date with the latest news from all around the world. Like and subscribe to the channel. Together we can do more. And let's get to the news. In today's episode, Hurricane Trami hits the Philippines. Quantum computer, miracle or disaster? Solar activity reaches 11-year high. Sam Altman announces new orb. What does it mean? A revolutionary new way to fight carbon dioxide and more. Chinese researchers have cracked cryptographic algorithms using a quantum computer. The findings were published in the Chinese Journal of Computers on September 30th. They said it was the first time a quantum computer posed a real and significant threat to encryption. While AES-256 is considered one of the most secure encryption standards, the researchers say quantum computers could soon be able to steal users' funds at high speed and in large volumes. While they said that attack did not reveal specific passwords, they were more successful and further developments could lead to more robust quantum attacks. Ethereum co-founder Vitalik Buterin said that a simple hard fork could solve the problem, and the infrastructure needed to implement a hard fork on the Ethereum blockchain could theoretically start being built tomorrow. Well, if you don't know what a quantum computer is, and you're interested in what its operating principle is based on, and what potential danger it conceals, like this video and write about it in the comments. On October 17th, Sam Altman, founder of OpenAI, demonstrated a new retinal scanning device called Orb that is required to obtain a world ID that proves humanity. What is World ID and what is going on? Worlds is the world's first blockchain built for people. The project's mission is to build the world's largest identity and financial network as a public infrastructure, transferring it to the ownership of participants. To start working with the World Protocol, a user needs to undergo World ID verification via a retinal scan. Such participants are entitled to claim free WLD tokens and voting rights regarding the future of the protocol. Using World ID, they will be able to prove that they are a real person on any platform that integrates with the protocol, including Web3 systems, social networks, and government programs. More than 2 million people from more than 30 different countries have been verified in Orb. In Latin America, starting next year, Orb will be ordered to your home. Quite an ambitious idea, don't you think? If it weren't for the fame of the founder of this project, one would think that it would go into the shadows. But here it seems that we are witnessing the formation of a completely new infrastructure that can potentially become an integral part of every person's life. Is it bad? I think yes. The world is moving far from its nature, from friendship, love, creativity, self-knowledge. We are moving towards tokenization, digitalization, AI integration, robotization. Events are so fast that when you wake up, it may be too late to change anything. Like this video if you agree with me. Researchers from Nanyang Technological University have created a soft, grain-sized robot that can penetrate the body and be guided by magnetic fields to move to a specific target. Once there, it can quickly or slowly release a drug stored in its tiny body. The novelty is characterized by having four compartments that can carry and release different drugs. Although there are rare miniature robots that can carry multiple drugs, such robots cannot change the sequence and dosage of drug release. These robots have the potential to completely change a wide range of treatments in the future, said lead researcher, Associate Professor Lomgojong. This means that dozens of types of operations that require penetration into the body, necessary for the application of various drugs, can be replaced by a miniature robot that enters and exits the body without any damage. On Tuesday, NASA officials said the sun had reached solar maximum, which could last about a year. About every 11 years, at the peak of the solar cycle, the sun's magnetic poles switch places, and it goes from a quiet state to an active and stormy one. The most active period of the cycle, known as solar maximum, is accompanied by enormous flashes of light, energy emissions, and solar radiation, creating so-called space weather. This can affect satellites and astronauts in space, as well as communication systems such as radio and GPS and power grids on Earth. Scientists expect the maximum phase to last about another year, after which the sun will enter a phase of decreasing activity that will lead to solar minimum. Recently, I talked about the change of magnetic poles on the Earth. As we see in the example of the sun, violent processes occur inside, affecting even the Earth, located millions of kilometers away. One can only imagine what consequences await us when the poles change on our planet. The next news is shocking. Gur Simran Kaur was found dead in the oven of a Walmart in Nova Scotia on October 19. Her mother, who also worked at the store, tried to find her after being unable to reach her by phone. She found her charred remains later in the oven. Police have called the investigation complex and that it has not yet reached the point where the cause and manner of death have been confirmed. So far, more than $192,000 Canadian dollars has been raised for the family, but of course, that does not make up for the cost of their daughter's life. Gusimran Kaur was a beautiful young woman who came to Canada with big dreams. My condolences to the family. Scientists have invented a powder that can absorb carbon dioxide from the air. It could be a game changer in the fight against climate change. The results of the study were published in the journal Nature. This powder is capable of absorbing and storing as much carbon dioxide as a mature tree. Adsorption means you can then release it elsewhere, allowing you to clean the air and store the CO2 in a place where it won't be released back into the atmosphere. The researchers say the powder opens up new horizons in the fight against climate change and that there is nothing like it at the moment. Cool, let's just hope this technology doesn't accidentally die. Anthropic has announced the release of a new model, Claude 3.5 Haiku. The main innovation is the revolutionary computer use function, which allows AI to control a computer like a human, view the screen, move the cursor, press buttons, and enter text. This is the first AI model on the market to offer this feature in open beta testing. Despite its experimental nature and some limitations, the technology is already being used by companies such as Asana, Canva, and DoorDash to automate complex multi-step tasks. Before its release, the updated Claude 3.5 Sonnet model was tested at the US and UK Institutes for Artificial Intelligence Safety. And I will remind you that OpenAI recently announced the Swarm Framework test function for developers that can also perform tasks on websites or in the real world on behalf of the user. Believe me or not, very soon it will be the new trend. At least 76 people have died as Tropical Storm Trami batters the Philippines. Almost 320,000 people have been forced to flee their homes due to flooding and landslides, while 7,500 are stranded at airports and seaports. The storm is moving northwest. According to forecasters, if it does not change its trajectory, it could reach Vietnam on October 27th. After that, the storm could return to the Philippines next week. This is a disaster. Storms in these regions are quite common, but from year to year, their number and destructiveness only increases. Like and subscribe to the channel. Here I show the most interesting news. World is changing fast. New epidemics, restrictions on our freedoms, economic risks, wars, global climate change, the penetration of artificial intelligence into our lives. Will humanity be able to withstand all the trials? Will we be able to preserve our freedom and identity? Will we be able to unite for our own salvation? Most people do not regard the current situation as a threat. However, if the victim does not see the predator, this does not mean that there is no predator. You can hide in your cozy room under the blanket and hope that everything will pass you by. Or you can come out into the light and become a part of a new progressive community that can change the world. Like and subscribe to the channel. And remember, you decide to be or